Now, it also tells us why. The reason why is because, y'all ready? Say ready.
Ready.
The reason why is we, as believers in Christ, have a tendency to lean towards our own understanding. See, I know you've read this passage many times before, but let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. Now understand something. When I say the problem is that we lean towards our understanding, there might be another problem. It's very possible that some believers don't want God to direct all their life. Just some of them. Amen?
Amen.
Let me give you an example. Let's take the subject of salvation real quickly. Salvation. Going to heaven. If I was to mention, And say we didn't know, but if there was, everybody wants to go to heaven. I really believe it. Everybody wants to know that when they physically die, that they're going to be much better off. Amen? Amen? Everybody wants to know that. If I was to say, okay, here it is. According to the Word of God, in order to get to heaven, you've got to come to church X amount of times in your life. You can bet you would do everything in the world to do that. If I said, okay, you've got to give X amount of money. In order to get to heaven, you've got to give X amount of money. If that's what the Word of God said, you and I would do everything we could to give that amount of money. Amen?
Amen.
I mean, we want to get this settled. We want to make sure everything's okay. It doesn't work that way. God looks down at man and says, I want to have a family. I want them to be part of me. I want them in heaven with me. I want them to spend eternity with me. But they're not good enough. So I've got to send my only begotten. The word begotten son means one of a kind, cut away, no one else like him, to the cross. I've got to sacrifice him, and he'll pay the sins of everybody, all of mankind, no matter the nationality, the race, no matter the geographical location. It doesn't make no difference. I'll take care of it, and all they have to do is put their trust. Everybody say trust?
Trust.
All they have to do is put their trust in him, and they can have eternal life. We call that grace. In order to believe in grace, what you have to do is you've got to have faith. You got to have faith in grace. Have we ever seen Christ? No. Were we there when he was buried and resurrected from the grave? No. Whatever. But by grace, you're saved through faith. Faith is trusting in what God has done. Amen?
Amen.
Now, after that, you begin to live for God. You begin to live for Christ. And you know what? You're fired up. I'm saved. And you begin to learn a little bit about God's Word. And then something happens. As I begin to learn a little bit, and as I begin to grow, and as I begin to catch that spark, and as that flame begins to burn, I find out, after I'm saved, and I'm living for Christ, the three C's kick in. I find out that it takes courage. I find out that not only does it take courage, that it's challenging in my life. When I live for Christ, I find out there's a lot of challenges that takes place. I find out that it takes a lot of courage. And then I find out it takes something else. Change. As I begin to know more about Christ, and I begin to know more about my, and as I more about the Bible, and I begin to get fired up about God, and I get fired up about the Word of God, I begin to see that I need to change in my life, not worry about what everybody else is doing. Yeah. I need to begin to understand that if I'm going to live for God, it's going to take some courage, some guts. If I'm going to live for God, it's going to be challenging. Because God, watch this, God's not going to call you to do nothing that won't challenge your faith. Because if you don't challenge your faith, then you're never going to learn how to trust Him. So it takes a challenge. Okay? Now, What happens is we look at this grace part and we look at salvation and we say, wow, I'm saved. And then all of a sudden when we look at all these three C's and we look at all the things that come with it about living for Christ, we begin to back up. And we begin to lean towards our own understanding. And we begin to lean on some of God's Word. You see, what happens, what you begin to realize is the most important thing in the world is I'm saved. I'm saved. It doesn't matter what happens to me. I'm going to heaven. I'm saved. Well, what about living for Christ? Yeah, I know. What about coming to church? Yeah, I know. What about tithing? I know. What about all these? I know. But the most important thing is I'm saved. And that is the most important thing. But after that is living